Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all having a fantastic day. As you can tell by the title, today's video is going to be my travel makeup bag. We're going to be going through it. I'm going to be showing you guys what makeup I really travel with. And I also want to do this so you guys can see kind of what makeup I use on a daily basis, because it always kind of switches up. Since I have so much, I do try to cycle through my items. But I thought today I'd sit down and share with you like my top things that I take traveling. So I'm actually leaving for Mexico pretty soon, and I'm super excited about that. So I thought, since I'm packing my makeup anyways, why not share with you? So I have a bunch of these e.l.f. bags right here behind me, and usually when I pack my makeup I use this gray bag right here. I don't have any like fancy makeup bag that I use, because a lot of times my family goes on road trips and I don't really need anything fancy, because I do take a lot of it just on the go with me. So I've just never really liked those like full-on makeup bags where you kind of put everything. I kind of like to be able to separate stuff. So I had one and this was part of it, so I do use this a lot and I just put everything in it. Everything fits really nicely. But for this trip I thought I'd have it more split up, because the packing for this Mexico trip that I'm going on is kind of complicated, since I'm not taking any luggage, like I'm not checking in any luggage. I'm taking a carry-on and a backpack, so if I have to split up my makeup I will, and that's why I'm packing these e.l.f. bags. And these ones I just got when I went to the e.l.f. store in New York, and this is what they gave when you bought stuff there. This was like the bags they gave out. So I use these because they're super light, so they're not going to add on to the weight of any of my luggage, and they're just a really light material, and if I end up not needing the bag I can fold it up and it doesn't take up any room. So I have three of these, and this is what I am really taking with me. So let's start with this first bag right here. This is my face stuff right here. Alright, so let's start with so this is what the bag looks like on the inside, and I have all my skin products in here, like all my face makeup products. So let's start with primer, of course. I feel like that's a good place to start. I'm bringing two primers with me. The first one is the Milani Prime Protect SPF 30 Face Primer, and I absolutely love this. I used it a lot on my California trip this summer, and I use it almost every day. I liked it under makeup, just alone, without makeup, and it was a great, like, second step moisturizer, too. A lot of times in the summer, I don't wear that much moisturizer. Recently, I've been using just some hyaluronic acid and no moisturizer, just because I find some moisturizers clog my pores. So I have I don't really use moisturizer anymore. So when it is like humid, if I am in a humid climate, then I usually just use this on my skin in the summer, or if I'm going somewhere where I don't want my skin to get harmed by the sun. So this has SPF 30 in it, which is all I need, and it's just a really great primer and a really nice base step. And then I'm also bringing my mini Tatcha. This one is absolutely perfect for traveling. So this is what I've been using lately for travel, and it's amazing. It really does the job. This is like my favorite primer of all time, so having a little mini one to travel with is perfect. And then next is a foundation. So I have this Physicians Formula, the Healthy Foundation Brightening Complex, and I hate and like traveling with this one. I don't like traveling with it just because it is a glass bottle, it is heavier and stuff, so that's like something I don't like about it. But this foundation is just so great, especially for traveling, because it blends out so easily. It's really light on the skin, it doesn't make me break out, and it gives me just enough coverage. It's really nice because when I do go traveling places that like are warm and I get a tan, I don't need that much coverage, so this is just the right amount when I go out and stuff, and I really like this one. I'm bringing my L'Oreal Full Wear just because this one is such great coverage. And I like to use this under foundation, and then I'm also bringing my Maybelline Fit Me in the shade 15. This is just for spot concealing when I'm going like out, not for the night, and I'm not doing a full face of makeup. I'll just use some of this. And then, even though I love my Coty Airspun powder to death, like that is my number one powder for sure, I am bringing my Milani this time because this one has a screw-on cap instead of just the press-on, and that Coty Airspun one is way too messy and way too big to be bringing, so this one is perfect. This one does a really great job at setting your makeup as well, so this will do the job just right, so I'm just bringing this. And then for the rest of face products, I'm bringing bronzer, of course. I'm bringing my Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. The reason I bring this one is because I can contour and bronze with this, so I don't need two products, and really light on the skin. I can even use this on bare skin and it doesn't look muddy or anything like that. And then I have this Milani Baked Blush in the shade Dolce Pink. I'm bringing this one because it's a really pretty pink shade and I can wear this with warm tone or cold tone looks. It kind of works with everything. The luminosity in it makes your skin look so nice, especially on trips, so I love that about it. And then we also have the Anastasia Beverly Hills Amrezy highlighter. This is my all-time favorite highlighter, and especially when I get a tan, this gold shade just pops even more on my skin, so I have to bring this. It's my favorite and no way I'm traveling without this. And the last product is my Milani Make It Last setting spray. I like this one because it's pretty small compared to like other setting sprays that are like bigger in size. So this one's nice because it's kind of compact and it does make your makeup last a long time. It refreshes your skin if you're looking a little powdery. So all in all, an amazing setting spray to bring. All right, let's move on to the next little baggie. So this is going to be eyes and lips. And I'm also bringing my gingerbread, Too Faced Gingerbread Palette. The reason I'm bringing this one is I have a lot of shades to work with in here. I can create a very, you know, just simple brown tone look just with the neutrals in here. I can also add a bit of purple, or I can use this pink and orange to kind of spice up the look and add some color. So I feel like this palette has a really nice shade selection and I can use it in a lot of different ways. So that's why I'm bringing this one, because I always like on vacation to have, you know, a bunch of neutrals and then some pops of colors that I can incorporate. So that palette just really does it for me. I of course am bringing some eyebrow products. I'm bringing my NYX micro brow pencil. You guys know this is my number one brow pencil. Even though I don't really do my eyebrows anymore, like I don't have them filled in at all today, I still bring it just in case one day I'm like, wow, my eyebrows really don't look good today, so I need to fix them up. And then of course some eyebrow gel to keep them in place. This is the Wet n Wild Mega Clear Brow and Lash Mascara. I'm bringing a clear one so that if I go in the water and stuff, I don't have to worry about stuff running down my face. And then I'm also bringing a liquid liner. This is the NYC liquid liner. This is like my absolute favorite one, so I have to bring this one that so I can get like sharp wings like this while I'm on vacation. And then my X Fiber mascara from L'Oreal is my absolute favorite. I love this one because I can get really subtle lashes using the step one and just really lengthen them. And then I can use step two to really add that volume and thicken them up, and then I don't really need falsies while I'm traveling either. All right, and then you guys know, of course, I have to bring my liquid eyeshadows. I cannot do eye looks anymore without these. So these are my Milani Hypnotic Lights eyeshadows, and I have to bring these just because they make any eye look pop, and especially when I'm going out and stuff, I really want my makeup to look all glam. So these are the perfect trick for that, and then you can just bring these to do your different eye looks. They're not messy at all. They're really easy to use on the go. So I'm bringing the shade 03, which is a really pretty purple, 04, which has like pink and yellow in it, and then 01, which is a gold shade. So these are my favorite. If you haven't seen my video on these, I'll link down below, but these are like literally the best little liquid eyeshadows ever, so I have to have these. Next, we have a bunch of lipsticks. So definitely when I'm traveling, lipsticks and lip products are the things that I bring the most of, just because you can kind of wear the same thing on your face and on your eyes every day, but if you switch up your lip, it'll kind of make it look like you're wearing a different makeup look, if that makes sense. So of course I'm bringing like my nudes. I have one lip liner that I'm bringing, and this is the Rimmel Coffee Bean. I do like to bring a darker color because I could even wear this under reds, under pinks, and mostly under nudes. So this is a very versatile pencil. I do need to sharpen it before I go so that it's nice and sharp for the trip. But yeah, one of my favorite lip liners for sure right there. And then some nude liquid lipsticks. One of my favorites is the Stila. So I'm definitely bringing this because it's a really nice nude. And then I'm also bringing this Amore Satin Matte. And then the matte from Milani in the shade Precious. It's like a pinky tone. And then I have the Satin Matte in the shade Indulge. I actually have these two mixed on my lips today, and it just gives like a nice rosy, deeper tone, but it's not too deep, if that makes sense. So I kind of like these colors for going out. And then I also am bringing just a regular lipstick. This is Milani Matte Innocence, and this is a really nice nude because I can literally layer this over any lip combo, like even now. Just adding a little bit will lighten up that center, but I can wear this with a lot of different lip combos. And then, of course, I do have to bring a nice bright red lipstick too. I can't go on vacation without bringing a red. It's an essential. So I'm bringing this one in the shade Pucker Up from Tattoo Junkie. And then to go over that, I'm bringing my Milani Matte Passion. It's like a red orange. And I'm bringing this because I can apply a little bit with the Tattoo Junkie liquid lipstick and just have a red lip. Or I can just apply this and have like a red orange lip. So I thought this was a great versatile color. And then of course I have to bring some lip glosses to make sure my lips look glossy when I want them to. So I'm bringing my two favorites, my Milani Soft Rose Keep It Full lip gloss. This one is amazing. It just makes your lips so moisturized and nice. And then also my little mini Buxom, because this one is really nice over more cool toned lip looks. So I really like this one. And the last category we have is brushes and tools and stuff like that. This is definitely an essential part to have in your makeup kit. All right, so first tool is tweezers, and usually I bring tweezers for applying eyelashes, but I'm not bringing any eyelashes on this trip, just my L'Oreal mascara. So these I'm just gonna use for touching up my eyebrows and stuff while I'm gone. Next we have foundation brush, and I'm bringing this Real Techniques Expert Face Brush. I like this one because it's thick enough that I can do all my makeup with it. I can also go under the eyes. It's just really, really easy to use and gets makeup done really fast. And then kind of as a second to that, I'm bringing this deluxe concealer brush from Real Techniques. I really like this one when I'm trying to spot conceal, because instead of applying it with a little brush, like concealer or something on spots, you can use this to kind of buff, and it blends it out into the skin really nicely, and it's really easy for touch-ups. I can also use this right underneath my eyes, so one of the a really key brush in my makeup routine. Then for the rest of the face, I'm bringing this Real Techniques blush brush for my bronzer, because it's really easy just to buff on. I can use it to kind of contour the nose a little bit. Really, really simple to use this one, so that's why I'm bringing it. And then we also have this Sonia Kashuk fan brush. I've been using this lately to apply my blush, and it just applies it so perfectly because it kind of wisps it on, and then I can also kind of get on my nose with my blush, and it's really easy to use. And of course, we can't forget about a highlighter brush. This is just essential to make sure you're all glowy, and this is just a Morphe M510. I just really like these small little brushes for highlighter. And then for powder, I am bringing a Poof, just because I like how Poofs kind of press the powder in, and then it's really easy to touch up your makeup with these as well. If your makeup's looking a little bit cakey or oily, you can kind of press this on the skin. It kind of fixes everything up for you. Alright, so next we have some eye brushes, and I'm not packing too heavy this year. As I said, I'm bringing what I need and working with it. So first brush is just a fluffy brush that I can use in my crease. Then we have this Morphe M518, and I can use this again in the crease and to deepen up the look as well. I also am bringing this Morphe M505. This one I really like for packing on the outer corner to deepen up looks. And then I'm bringing this Morphe M441, and I'm bringing this one for my pinks and oranges so that I can add bright shades in there, because I do need two crease brushes in case I do like a neutral look or a bright look. And then I'm bringing a little brush for highlighting the inner corner and brow bone, and then this Morphe M431. It's a little pencil brush, and this is perfect for doing the lower lash line. So, as I said, not taking too many brushes. All right, guys, so that's really it for my travel makeup this year. I've done this video in the past, like years and years ago, so I thought I'd kind of update you guys on what I travel with or what makeup I kind of pack. Even if I'm going somewhere overnight, this is usually the makeup I'll go to. The only things that really change would be like palettes or maybe lipsticks if I'm just going for a certain look that night. But this is really the gist of the makeup I like to travel with. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and enjoyed seeing my favorite makeup at the moment. But anyways, I hope you're having a fantastic day or night whenever you're watching this. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and also make sure to turn on my post notification bell so you get notified every single time I upload a new video. And I will see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.